Olá amigos, hello friends, in this video we are going to continue our journey towards the flexible gallery, the gallery that we adapt to the size of the screens. Okay, so here we stopped at this point where we have a header and a gallery that are already adapting to the size of the screen. But I mentioned we could do better because in the previous video we had to work in the width and height of the gallery and put some formulas here to make it work. And I mentioned that if we work with nested containers, that problem is solved. And just to show you how nested containers are actually used, look at the screen that I have here. We can see that we have container in the top, container in the left, container in the middle. And if we look again, the main structure is a container and all the other containers are inside it. Actually, the header container, then we have one container with two containers inside. So it's widely used. And this screen, it's even generated from a template screen that we have here in the new screen, and we can select sidebar. This is the screen that I used, the module I used to build this adapted screen here, this responsive screen. Okay, but this is for later. Let's look how we can do exactly like this, look exactly like this using containers. So let's go back to the screen number one, and we see here that we have a container in the top, that's the header, and a gallery, and I mentioned that we could use more containers. So what we are going to do is, we are going to have a container with this container inside and the gallery inside it. So I will just resize everything. They are going to lose their formulas that we did in the last video. If I play the app right now, we are going to see that they don't adapt anymore. And we are going to insert a vertical container to put them inside it. So I'm going to go here in the plus icon, search for vertical, select it. I will just make it bigger. Later, we will need to put some formulas here in the container to make it occupy the full screen. And we already know the formulas based on the previous video from the playlist. Let me do a Ctrl X on this container as a whole thing, and then just paste here, Ctrl V. It's pasted inside the container. We barely see because there is the gallery also behind it, and the container is transparent. So let me change the background color of the container. I have the container selected. Let me see if I got the correct container. It's container 12. See, it's the new container. In my case, it's called container 12. And the container with the header is called container 11. Let's already rename this as a good practice. So let's call con header example in my case. And for the outside container, I will call con main container example. So for the con main container, just put an extra S. Container example, I will put the color as white. So I will see it better, or even maybe another color, gray color, so I can see the container in a better way. Okay. If I click in the container now, I see that I have another container inside it, and this container is actually occupying the full size of the main container. Let me remove this flexible height here. So now it just has its fixed height, that's 74. Let me change to 60. And let me make it stretch to the size of the main container. So in order to do that, we need to make it stretch here in the aligning container property. Right below, we have this stretch that will stretch to the width. So it takes the width of the container, doesn't matter what it is. Okay, now we can just cut the gallery and paste inside the main container. So Ctrl X to cut, and I'm going to paste here. Selected the main container and pasted. One thing that happens all the time until this day that I'm recording this video is that the things lose their position, their reference for position, and go all to the zero inside the gallery. It loses the normal configuration that it had before when it was outside the container. I don't like this because now I have to do manually and organize again. But that's okay. It's part of the game. I'm sure that at some point that will be fixed. So if we know that we are going to have this structure, it's better to have since the beginning and create the gallery already inside it and configure it. It's okay. Let's just move things. Put them in the correct size, correct place. So here's the model. This is the size. This is the class, and this is the name. Later we are going to work on this formula. So I just put like this, and then soon we are going to work on the formulas to position correctly. Okay. Now we have the gallery inside the vertical container. So we have the vertical container, then the horizontal container inside it, that's the header, and the gallery together with the other container. The gallery has already flexible height, has the stretch activated, so it will automatically take the remaining size inside the container, and we don't need to worry about the formulas, because it will automatically stretch to the remaining space, and we don't have to put the parent.width and parent.height in the gallery, for example. But the last thing we need to do is we need to make this container take the size of the screen. So let's position it in the very beginning, and for the main container, we need to change the width to parent.width, the height to parent.height. And now we have the app behaving very responsive. Okay, yes. The only thing we need to do is now make the logic for the values here inside the gallery to align with the labels in the top in the header. So in the next video, I'm going to show this formula, and always that we move, that the header resize, the values are going to be aligned. And then we are going to start thinking about how we are going to do to make the text decrease the font if the screen is too narrow. So I will leave the link to the next video right in the end of this class. If you arrived until here, please leave a comment in the video about what you're thinking about these classes, and with any suggestions of improvements or future content. It's very important to me that you participate and you interact in the lessons. See you there in the next class.